and welcome to the Governor Mifflin High School Auditorium. So that all of our patrons can enjoy the show to its fullest, we ask that you observe the following rules. There is no food or drink in the auditorium. Please turn off all cell phones. Please enter and exit the auditorium during applause only. There is no flash photography. There is no standing in the aisles due to performers moving in the aisles and per order of the fire marshal. Thank you for coming, and we hope you enjoy the performance.
Thank you. So I just want to take a second and acknowledge Anthony Maldonado, who conducted that last piece. Not only did Anthony conduct that piece in the concert, but he also got the opportunity to rehearse that piece with our band throughout the spring. We talked about a piece that he might like to do from the pieces that I had selected for the concert, and he chose that one and was able to work through the entire rehearsal process. And as part of his graduation plans, he plans to go on to major in music education at Westchester University. And I thought that would be a great opportunity for him to be able to conduct this. So let's give him one more round of applause, please. And our next piece is Incantation and Dance by John Barnes Chance.
Thank you.
All right, so once again, I would like to thank you all for coming tonight on the first day we've had without rain in, what, like 3 months or something? We very much appreciate you being here with us. Before we move on to our next piece, I would like to let you know that there are shoe fly pies for sale in the lobby. GMMA has some shoe fly pies out there if you would like to grab one on your way home. They're from a new bakery this year, I'm told. Wixson's has closed. So we have a new bakery supplying our shoe fly pies. Please do visit the table out in the lobby on your way home tonight. Before we play the next piece, I'd like to bring up four members of our band. The next piece that we're gonna play is called An American Elegy. And this song was written in response to the tragedy that happened at Columbine High School 20 years ago. As a matter of fact, 20 years ago this year. So I thought this would be a good opportunity for us to perform this piece and kind of think about what that event meant to our society. And before we play the piece, I've asked these four members of our band to come and sing the Columbine High School alma mater for you. And I think it's important for all of us to think about what this piece means. Leonard Bernstein said that our response to violence will be to make music more passionately than we ever have before. So I think it's really important to reflect on pieces like this when we got the opportunity to play them. So going along with that, I'd like to ask you that once we, once they sing our the alma mater for Columbine High School, then we perform this piece, I'd like to ask that you hold your applause and instead just take a moment to reflect on how fortunate we are that our community has not been affected by this type of tragedy, and in such a divided country that hopefully students, parents, educators, politicians can all come together so that something like this never happens again and students don't have to go to school afraid.
Yeah.
As we make some preparations for our final piece, I'd like to recognize a few people. If you are a member of the class of 2019, please stand. Let's give these folks a big round of applause. They put up with a lot from all of us in the music department, so we definitely owe them a debt of gratitude, and we will miss you all very much next year. Please do stay in touch. We had several students qualify for Berks County All-Star Junior Band. If you were in Junior County Band, please stand. If you auditioned and made Senior County Band, please stand. Please stay standing. If you auditioned and qualified for District Band, please stay standing. If you made Region Band, please stand. If you are a member of our three-time Atlantic Coast Champion Indoor Percussion, please stand. If you are a member of our Indoor Color Guard, we are very proud of all of the work that goes into the students that participate in the extracurricular activities. They put in a lot of hours here at school, outside of the school day, and we're very, very fortunate that we have so many students who participate in those programs. One more thing. We have an award to present tonight. This is the John Philip Sousa Band Award, and this is given to the student who has earned the most points in band activities. So participating in marching band, concert band, jazz band, county, district, region, all state bands. Jazz band, did I say jazz band? Yeah. Orchestra, if they are in orchestra on their band instrument. Indoor percussion, that might be all of it, I think. Yeah. So, this year's student who is receiving the John Philip Sousa Band Award is Caitlin Walton. Very happy to say that Caitlin is continuing her music education at Shenandoah University. Are you possibly music ed, possibly other bassoon-related things? So we'll close our portion of the concert with Lincolnshire Posey.
So how about a round of applause for Mr. Cassano? So, I know you came in here like 3 years ago, and taking over Dunier's position, and it's a new thing, and we're like drum tech and stuff here before, but just all of us have been impacted greatly by everything that you do, and we just wanted to say thank you for everything that you do for us. So, thank you. also is Mrs. Cassano here?
She was.
Yeah. We have flowers for you too. So yeah, from all 22 of us seniors, just thank you both for everything that you do for every kid that comes through this program, and know that they're in very good hands.
And now, we will close our portion of the program with Lincoln Chair Posey.
Sorry about that. Very important equipment.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. All right, we'll get you back to the music very soon, but a couple things we've got to do. First of all, thank you very much for your attendance this evening. I am extremely proud of what this group was able to accomplish this year, and I'm glad that you could be here to see it. So thank you again. This is your final official reminder about the Shoofly Pies. They're out in the front lobby. Go get them. I don't need any. I'm going to go ahead and do all the thank yous now. We still have a little bit more orchestra and then some jazz band, but I'm just going to do it now. First of all, thank you to the students for their hard work and for understanding that making music is about giving themselves and their audience a fulfilling experience. Thank you. Many thanks to you, their parents, for encouraging their musical endeavors, encouraging them to practice, paying for the instrument, so on and so forth. Guys, give your parents some props. Well, I hope my kids are that enthusiastic about me someday. Thank you to our administrators for their undying support of what we're doing down here in the music department. The GM faculty for allowing students to miss class all the time to come to sectionals and make a program like this possible. Thanks to the custodial staff for putting up with all of our crazy. To the communications office and the print shop for putting together the beautiful programs you're looking at tonight, and to GMMA for everything that they do, especially the pies. Give all those people some. This group of seniors this year is a very special one to me. So I'm just gonna stop and acknowledge them real quick. Could all the seniors just stand for a moment? Winds, brass, you know, everybody. Okay, thank you. I also want to acknowledge our students that participated in honors festivals this year. We'll start with Junior County Orchestra. Would any participants please rise? Senior County Orchestra. District Orchestra. Regional Orchestra. And PMEA All-State Orchestra. Okay, so while we're on the topic of seniors and people doing good things, there is one more thing I must do before our last piece. Every year, I have the privilege of choosing a recipient for the National School Orchestra Award. If you give me a moment, I will pull out the plaque and just read to you exactly what it says. This award is in recognition of singular merit and outstanding contributions to the success of the school orchestra, for displaying an unusual degree of loyalty and cooperation, and for exemplifying the high standard of conduct that is the aim of the school instrumental program. Every school, in Berks County at least, gives national school awards. Not every school, however, is able to accompany them with a $50 check for the student, and that is many thanks to GMMA. Go ahead, give them one more round of applause. And without further ado, this year's award goes to a young lady who is a quiet but outstanding and loyal leader who I'm going to miss a great deal, Sophia Ferreira.
Thank you. now it's on. There we go. On the topic of awards, if you've been here before, you know that every year, the seniors give a gift to our director for putting up with us for four or just two or whatever, the amount of years we've been here. And believe me, we are a crew. Yeah, at times, talkative at times. But Mr. Leonowitz is by far one of the best, one of the best people I've ever met. He's one of the kindest, friendliest, most dedicated, trashiest, sassiest people I've ever met. And I hope our gifts to you reflect that. So I think when I say from the class of 2019, thank you so much, Mr. Leonowitz. The other seniors to explain what we got him, because it's a story.
Okay. So, as some of you may know, may not know, Mr. Leonowitz's first year of teaching here, which was like 3 years ago, our sophomore year, one day he decided it was a great idea to put his foot up on one of the chairs in the front row, and that ripped his pants. But these weren't just any pair of pants that he had, these were his favorite bright red pair of pants from Kohl's. So, yeah. So last year's class got him a little sewing kit to fix any future rips in his pants, but we figured, you know, it's not the same. So I went on Kohl's website, and they didn't have the same exact pair of red pants, but these were like sea salt red, so they were the closest to it. So there's your pair of pants.
Then he would buy us candy, which I don't know why we chose candy, not like college tuition or something, but who knows? Anyway, we decided to get him a baton so that his baton would never break, and we made an engraving on it, and it says Trash from the class of 2019, so enjoy.
But the part of the story she's leaving out is that I won the bet. I never snapped the baton. I told her they're indestructible.
I was kind of banking on it, but we never got there, so.
Well, now this one really won't break. And if it will break, we'll probably come for you for that. But anyway, so. Sorry, Mom. Stuff, and Mr. Leonowitz has always been very accommodating in letting me keep a bunch of messy paint and very large canvases in his room during rehearsal, which is pretty generous considering coffee isn't allowed in some cases. But he's been asking me about this for a while, and I don't know, I think you should just let it speak for itself, I guess. Yeah. I mean, I don't.
my old man's cardigan on. I love it. For those of you who didn't already figure it out, it's me. Thank you very much, seniors. I am just, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Newer teachers typically, I have to be careful how I say this, that they look forward to the year when they only, they look forward to the year when their seniors were freshmen their first year, because then everybody is a Leonowitz kid. But I'm really very sad to lose this group because they were the last ones that gave me a chance when they were already used to a different situation. So thank you again.
Okay,
Give us a couple seconds to just reset. You will soon be in the capable hands of Chamber, GMHS Chamber, String Ensemble, and ultimately Mr. Ben Visconti's. Give us a second. Hi there, folks. Welcome back. Okay, so as the stage is transitioned over to jazz band, we have one piece here with our chamber ensemble. This is an auditioned group. I auditioned right at the end of the year prior. So I'm running auditions for next year right now, as a matter of fact. But this group is very gracious to put up with my crazy at like 6:45 in the morning. They come in before school and we rehearse, and they really have done great things. So they'll be presenting to you a piece called Rhythm Dances, which is a very fast, lively, emotional piece by Brian Balmages. And then after that, Ben Visconti, cellist, and I have something else for you over the piano, okay? So enjoy while jazz band gets set up. last small act of the evening, and then we'll let jazz band bring this home. French composer Camille Saint-Saëns is responsible for a set of small pieces called the Carnival of the Animals. Each one is meant to describe a different animal. This one is written specifically for cello and piano and is called The Swan. It's one that you'll know it when you hear it if you don't know it already. And Ben came to me asking if we could do this on the spring concert, and I said, absolutely. And he said, do you know anyone that could play the piano? And I said, yeah. And then he said, well, if it's too much, if you don't want to do it, if it's too much, I can ask a student. I was like, no, I'll do it. I'll do this with you. So here we go. Jazz band should be with you momentarily. Thank you very much.
Alex Colder on the trumpet. Give him one more hand. So before we play our last tune, I do have our jazz award that we give away at this concert. This is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, and this goes to a student who has excelled in jazz throughout his career at Governor Mifflin. And I'm proud to give this year's award to Max Migrowski. also, before we play our last tune here, I'd like to recognize our jazz band seniors. Stand, or you know, raise your hand if you're already standing. This year also, we had three students make it to Berks All-Star Jazz Band. Please stand, raise your hand. And also, Cormac Costello this year made it to District Jazz Band. So once again, I'd like to thank everybody for coming tonight. I hope you had a good time here spending your evening with us. And we're going to close the concert with Attitude Dance. But wait.
Hello, good evening. Thanks for coming out. Let's get a quick hand for Mr. Cassano. Mr. Cassano is probably the best band director we've all had, ever. And, you know, it really shows he takes good care of us. So we'd like to take good care of him and present him with this present. Chef Allen's, everybody. And that's it. Thank you.
Cormac Costello, Ben Visconti, Trent Hefner, Lane Racing, Nate Wirt, and Max Podrowski soloed on that one. Governor Mifflin Statesman. Thank you everyone very much for coming tonight. I hope you had fun. Have a great night. Safe trip home.